Thank you all for coming. I'd like, first of all, to introduce myself. My name is John Hines, and I'm United States Senator from Pennsylvania. And I'm also chairman of the National Republican Senatorial Committee, which means I'm following very closely, as I'm sure you are, the reelection campaign of your United States Senator, Paula Hawkins. As a colleague of Senator Hawkins, I want you to know how important she is to us. And because I'm aware of the legislation she's passed and is continuing to initiate, I also know how important she is to Florida. As a matter of fact, Paula Hawkins is a senator this country ought to be very proud of and very grateful for. Paula has taken up the cause of so many Americans that have needed her help, and she's been entirely effective at seeing that help was delivered. She has made us in the Senate come to grips with problems that we had either had frankly overlooked or that we didn't know were possible to attack in such a successful way. You know, of course, that she's been the dominant voice for children in this country, making sure that there are federal mechanisms in place to protect them from abuse and that the government employ its resources to trace and find missing children. Your senator is a national leader in the war against drugs. Because she knows how many victims drugs claim, among the young and among crime victims who lie in the path of drugs, she has refused to accept their inevitability in this country. Paula has used every means at her disposal to fight drugs, personal diplomacy, the national defense apparatus of this country, and has even managed to reshape our foreign policy to punish drug-producing countries. The Hawkins Amendment, passed by both houses of Congress, is a vital piece of legislation in this regard. Paula Hawkins is in the arena every day fighting for what she believes in and what she knows is right. For children, for women, for the financial security of the elderly, and for the environmental and quality of life issues that are so important to Florida. She is, to me, one of the bravest, hardest working, and determined women I've ever met. But rather than my telling you about Paula, I'm going to let her actions speak for themselves.
It is now my pleasure to present the 1985 recipient of the American Legion Auxiliary's Woman of the Year Award for her efforts in prevention of child abuse, a very important program to the American Legion Auxiliary.
Senator Hawkins, I just cannot adequately tell everybody here how proud, as national president from the great state of Florida, that my own senator is the recipient of this award bestowed upon her by 1 million members of the American Legion Auxiliary. I am very proud of all the work she has done to prevent child abuse. I know that you are, and I want you to all know that the state of Florida is too. Very proud of her. Wow. It's gorgeous.
24 years and 1 month after the failed Bay of Pigs operation, the United States today successfully invaded Cuba. It was done by the Voice of America, using a new 50,000-watt radio station transmitting from the Florida Key.
Muy buenos días y bienvenidos a Radio Martí.
Radio Martí went on the air this morning 4 months late, but the reaction in Cuba was instantaneous. Even before the music and news broadcast started, the Cuban government canceled a recent immigration agreement. The Reagan administration has said Radio Martí's news broadcast will be fair, not propaganda, that Cuban citizens need a source of news not controlled by Castro.
I think that a good informed citizens can hold the Cuban government or whatever government more accountable for their own actions.
In 1982, the Cubans used their radio power to push American stations off the air as far away as Salt Lake City. But supporters of Radio Martí downplay the threats of Cuban retaliation, saying they are not new.
He'll say he'll do anything, but you can't back down in front of a two-bit dictator.
She's from the great state of Florida, the dynamic Paula Hawkins. Come on in, Senator Paula Hawkins.
Commitment to equal rights and opportunity for all. Whatever others may do, the Republican Party condemns racism, bigotry, and anti-Semitism.
Trade and aid. That's the key to stopping the flow of illegal drugs. But what will it take for the administration to uphold the law as it is spelled out in my amendment? Will it take another kidnapping? Will it take another death? It always seems to be the case in this country that they never put a stoplight on the corner until after there's been an accident. That kind of thinking has got to stop. It's time for the United States to get out in front in wiping out drugs at their source. It's time to use the leverage we have at our disposal to see that it's done.
Millions of children are reported missing every year, and thousands are never found. 1 year ago, the Missing Children Act was signed into law. My effort to see this bill through Congress was inspired by the dedication of John and Reve Walsh, who after the death of their son pushed for passage of my bill to help find missing children. Their story has been portrayed in a television movie which will air October the 10th at 9 p.m. Please watch Monday night and focus your attention on the need to protect our children.
I don't think anyone can imagine, I hope they never experience it, the feeling of losing a child. It's unlike any other grief. It's like any other, unlike any other loss. And as bad as that nightmare is, the feeling that no one's helping, that no one's looking, and the institutions that are supposed to protect your children don't and don't care. I felt that way until I met Senator Hawkins. And my feelings for her are about as strong as one can imagine, because she's concerned with the welfare of children in this country. She has battled for their rights. She has stood up when others wouldn't stand up. She has battled a system that didn't work. And even though there is little reward or recognition in the passage of legislation for children, she still continues to battle for those little silent voices.
We now have a plan that can bring together the great resources of the Spirit of America, which you have talked about in your private sector initiatives, into a partnership with government so that we can do a better job in making this country safe, as I mentioned, for our young people.
I've read your plan for a public-private partnership to encourage child safety, and I concur with your proposals, and I am here today to sign both the proclamation for National Child Safety Awareness Month and the executive order concerning the Child Safety Partnership.
I'd like to show a picture of a child that's missing from Tampa, Florida. Her name's Jennifer Sophia Martelez. She's from Tampa. Jennifer will be 10 years old in just 6 weeks.
From Washington, D.C., the United States Chamber of Commerce presents It's Your Business, a weekly series of debates on vital issues affecting you.
I was one of the authors of the Job Training Act with Senator Quayle and Senator Kennedy. Senator Hatch, and that replaced CETA, which was a make-work bill. We have a performance standard in the Jobs Training Act. These are going to be managed by businessmen, and indeed will tell us where the vacancies are. Train women, for instance, that have been displaced homemakers who are part of this unemployment trend, and take care of their, pay for child care while they are being retrained, and they must have a job at the end of their training or that pick is no longer funded.
We have listened for years about the quality of life in Florida, what is happening to the quality of life. And basically, we can live without a lot of luxuries in this state. We know that. You don't have to have a lot of overcoats, you don't have to have a lot of heat, etc. But we do have to have water, and it has to be good quality water. And we've talked for years about salt intrusion from each side. The more we pump out of the aquifer here in this part of the state, with salt on both sides so close, it becomes a big problem. Salt intrusion becomes a problem. And I want those that drink water in this state to understand that that's what we're talking about in this hearing. Having water that is safe for drinking come out of every faucet in every home.
I would love like to introduce someone who has joined with President Reagan to write a great chapter of American history. Someone who has mixed compassion with character, family with nation, someone who fights against drugs for the children of America, but above all, for the common good of all Americans. Ladies and gentlemen, a grandmother, a mother, a wife, an outstanding American, my friend, Senator Paula Hawkins.
I just want to tell all of you, my dearest and closest friends in Florida, how humbled I am that you all came to stand with me and my family this day. I want to continue to be the senator for people who don't have a senator, for parents desperately searching for missing children, for a sick person who would rather be cared for at home than to be institutionalized, for the single mother trying to make ends meet, for an abused child seeking guidance and protection, for parents trying to keep drugs out of America and away from their children, a senator for the people that the bureaucrats have forgotten, but for people that this senator will never forget.
That's your senator, and I think you have a right to be mighty proud of her. Proud enough to give of yourself and whatever else you can offer to support her campaign for reelection. You know that this election is going to be difficult against very powerful and well-financed opposition. But if we can raise the dollars to bring Paula and her accomplishments to every television home in Florida, I don't think anyone can top her. We all need Paula Hawkins in the Senate, and with your help, she's going to be there for everyone who needs her. Thank you.
This senator had a lot of victories in her first term as a United States senator, but there's so much left to do.
We've only just begun to live. So many roads to choose. We start out walking and learn.
Place where there's room to grow.
And yes, we've just begun.